Alright everybody, back again, trying to make more and more videos while all my days off here. So last video I showed you that Serial 9 shifter relocation and everything, so I was gonna work on the CD09 here this morning. So I wanna get this taken apart and see what we're getting into. The directions aren't really clear. So we're gonna just kind of wing this one and see how simple it is if we go the right direction. Disconnected the bottom part. I think this all needs to come off anyways. This hardware so we don't lose any of it. Bigger tool for that one. The old trusty stubby. Never let you down. Well, looks like I'm gonna have to run this pin out here. So, getting out here, guys. There's that little roll pin right there. Got to pull that out. Action slides right on there, so this whole back half of the shaft will come out. So I'm going to round up a couple more tools here real quick, and I'll be right back with you. I guess I forgot to hit record on that. The roll pins on that back shaft were a little difficult, and it seems to be a little rusted. Didn't come apart quite as easy as we wanted it to. But we got her off. One of the old roll pins shot somewhere. There was actually two roll pins in it, which is really, really weird. But we got her off of there, so that's all that really matters. Now, let's see what we have to do. Get this new setup on. So, there's a new shaft for it. We might need to sand this up a little bit. Yeah. I think I'm gonna need to clean this up just a hair. Make this a little bit easier for us. Get my nice little polish here with some 800 grit. Smooth it up a little. Make life a little more easier. Might even need a little bit of lube. Maybe just a little bit. So I've seen a couple of videos out there for these shifters, but I've never actually seen any install on them. So that was kind of the reason why I wanted to kind of show you guys the install on it. And you guys learn with me a little bit here. Looks like we got that in there. Big old monster roll pin here. See if we can get this in one shot. Actually, some in the directions about the roll pin. Apparently all they care about is depth. See if we can make one of these guys work. It's coming really handy.
I actually bought these for building ARs and stuff and guns. I got that nice dimple on them. Kind of holds right in to the socket there. It'd be easier if I could get it started. Probably wouldn't recommend anybody else putting this in a vise and closing it up a little, but sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta get it started is all. Secured this just a little bit better. Probably be a little or a lot easier if I would have actually secured the transmission. But you know, we like to do things the hard way here. Makes it fun, interesting. More. this little guy back in as well. Figured if Nissan wanted it doubled up, I guess I might as well double it up, huh? I think we got her. All right. Now that we got that in, oh, let's see what else we got here. I believe in a few minutes, and I will be right. Alrighty, welcome back. Welcome back. I think we now have everything set up right. Before I cut earlier, or after I cut earlier, I realized that I had put this on wrong. This nub needs to be on the bottom instead of up top here. So I had to knock those pins back out, put them back in, and now we're going to see if we can get her on here. A little difficult how it's all set up, but it should be able to get everything figured out here. Thank you.
like I said, a little difficult to get it on, but we'll get her all figured out here. Spacers in here. Whew.
Sorry there guys, brief pause. Currently I should check my SD card on the GoPro. So it ran out of memory. Alrighty, ready, ready. Let's see here. Let's see how she shoots. Second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth. Reverse. Nice little setup there. So I know the video was kind of all over the place. Hopefully it was a little bit instructional. It's definitely a lot more in depth than any videos I've seen with this shifter relocation. So anybody has any questions or anything, shoot me some comments. If you like the video, comment, like, subscribe, hit that notification bell up top, and we will see you guys next time. I'm getting ready to leave in 2 days to head back up to North Dakota, so I'll be gone for a couple weeks, but hoping by the time I get home that I have some more parts and we can start yanking the engine on the G35. So once again, like, comment, subscribe, hit that notification bell to receive notifications on any future videos. Till next time, everybody, have a good one.